Hello and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we'll continue working on Java database using MySQL. And in this video, we'll execute an SQL statement, a select statement, and we'll send this SQL statement through your program to the database to retrieve some data. So I'm excited to share this with you, and let's get started. Last time, we were able to connect to the database successfully. And now we'll start retrieving some data. In order to retrieve the data from the tables, we need to execute some SQL statement, and we'll go with select statement this time. So first, we'll create statement object, and here we'll use the connection object that we already created, and this is the first step. The second step, we'll create another object, result set, for the results, and here we'll use the statement object that is declared in line 17 above, and here we'll execute the query, and this is where to write the SQL statement. So let's go to Workbench, MySQL Workbench, and let's see that we have the database AP, and here are the set of tables, and this is the first table that we have for the accounts. I can click on this little icon here, and I can see the structure of my table. Here we have two fields. The first one is the account number, and the second one is the description. The first one is of type integer. The second one is of type var character. Now let's go back here and let's write the statement, select all the fields from this database. And here is the table that we want to access. Let's see if we have some results. I will use the while loop to walk through the results of this table. And here we will say next. If we have something in it, then I will do a print statement to print the result, the fields or the records. So first I will do this. Here r.get, and here the first one, as you know, it's get integer. Here we have two ways, an overloaded method. We have either to call it with the name of the field or the number of the field. So we'll go with the number of the field, number one, and here I will add comma to retrieve the second field, get string. So I'm using the string because we have the second value of type string. So we have this one missing. Let's run it and let's see the output now. We have some results now. Good job, guys. So write down if you are able to connect and retrieve some data or not. Write down in the comment section below. Let me know how it's going with you. Now, how to filter or minimize the results or to make some conditions. So here we will add some constraints, and here I can say where the account number is greater than 200. Let's run it, and here are the results. All the records have values of 200 or more. We can adjust this to 600 if you want, and we'll get less results. You see that? Less records here. Now, how about make this as a variable? What if we want to accept this value from the user? This what is called a dynamic query or dynamic SQL statement that will be covered in the next video. So make sure to subscribe and turn on the notification bell to receive the latest videos when it's published immediately. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. So thank you for watching, and see you next video. Good.